In our previous video, we saw REST as a technology to communicate the frontend with the backend. Generally, when a frontend and backend or any application is involved, what we are basically doing there is data manipulation. We are dealing with data. Now, what all operations are possible on a data or a record? We may fetch the information that we have previously stored. We may query for a particular information from the set of data we have. We may create fresh information. We may update an existing record, and we may delete it. So basically, this is what is happening in any application: data management. When a frontend is exposed to the user, user plays around with this data. And these are the four main operations a user would be doing: retrieving information, creating new information, updating the data, and deleting the information. So this is what we will be dealing with today: the four methods that REST is offering for a front-end to back-end communication. So as we said, the first operation that is available is called the GET method. The second is called the POST method. Third is called the PUT method. And the last is called the DELETE method. And these four methods are helping us solve the basic CRUD operation, which is create, read, update, and delete. That's nothing but CRUD. Let's take an example of a school application. Like any internal school application maintained, which is a record of the students in that school. So it will show you details of each student per class, their academic background, their score so far. So basically, this application is dealing with student data. So this is supposed the front end or the website of the school that we are trying to take an example. There is a backend service which manipulates the information, and there is a DB where the student information is stored. And these three components are interacting to form the school application. Now let's take this application as an example and see how we can implement the GET, PUT, POST, and DELETE methods of REST. Let's start with the GET method. The GET method, as the name says, is used to fetch data. So in the previous video, we had discussed how a REST basically operates. A REST is a URL which the frontend invokes on the backend. So basically, the backend has exposed one or more endpoints or URLs which the frontend is aware of. And the frontend knows exactly which URL to invoke when a particular task needs to get done. In a GET method, a frontend knows that, suppose the name of the school example that we have taken is Amity School, and a user has launched the website. A user is, say, the class teacher of class 10. And she needs to get the list of all students in class 10. This is where the user would just go in and search class 10 students on the website. Behind the scenes, the website knows to fetch class 10 student detail, it has to invoke a GET method on the backend. That URL, for example, is https://amityschool/class10/students. So here, if you look at the URL, there are some verbs or nouns. So Amity School, HTTPS Amity School, is the domain name of the application. Class 10 is the filter telling the backend that the user is trying to retrieve information of class 10, not of the entire school, but only of class 10. Now, what is the user looking for in class 10? It's looking for class 10 students. There can be another endpoint that is exposed to get the teachers that are assigned to class 10. In that case, the URL would be looking like https://amityschool/class10/teachers. So these are the various endpoints the backend is exposing, which enables the user to fetch information or to get information. Now let's take the second example here. Now, instead of all students in class 10, I am interested in one particular student detail. In that case, I'm going to say fetch information of Susie. So I am on the website searching by the name Susie. So behind the scenes, the front end is actually invoking the back end for students in class 10 and putting a filter that fetch me the detail of Susie, which is roll number, say 10. So the URL would look like http://amityschool/class10/students10. Here the backend knows that 10 means the roll number. So this is kind of the contract between the frontend and the backend. So the frontend knows what the backend understands, and the backend understands what the frontend is saying. So by using these two URLs and by sending the HTTP method as GET, the backend knows that the frontend is trying to fetch information. So in the response of the second query here, where we are trying to fetch student with roll number 10, the detail that the frontend would get is ID is 10, name is Susie, belongs to class 10, father's name is George, and the contact detail is 6612166. There can be many other attributes, but I've just taken these for an example. So this is how a GET method works. Let's get into the second method, which is the POST method. POST method is used for creating a fresh entry, a fresh record. Suppose a new student has joined the school, and that new student is getting enrolled to class 10. In this case, the POST method again is making use of the same URL, HTTP Amity School Class 10 Students. But here the method that we will be setting in the request will be POST. When I'm setting this method, the backend knows that the user is not trying to fetch the details. Instead, the user is trying to create something. So in this scenario, the backend will look into the body of the request that is coming in. The body will have a JSON request which has the detail of the record to be created. In the previous method, we saw that when a GET method is done using the URL https amity school class 10 students, a JSON body was received in the response. This time we are trying to create. So here we should be sending the JSON body in our request and the record would be created. So here I'm sending in the body as name is Jimmy, class is 10, father's name is John, and some contact number. So here I'm instructing the backend from the front end that create a student in class 10 with these details. Now you would think, from where is this information coming? That is simple. It's a form on the website. So the user opens the application, clicks on button say create new student. A form opens up. In that form, you type in the first name, the last name, class name, father's name, and the contact, and you press submit. That submit button does the magic. The submit button understands that this is a create request. It will form an HTTP request, which method post with the URL HTTP Amity School Class 10 Student, and the body with the details that the user had fed in inside the form. And this information goes to the backend. Backend looks into the request. It sees that the method is a post. That means the user should be created, and this record gets created in the database. Next time, if the user comes in and uses the GET method and says search students of class 10 on the website, it will list all the students, including this new record Jimmy that was created using the POST method. So in simple terms, POST is a method used to create a new entry. Now let's get into the third method, which is called the PUT. PUT method is usually used to update an existing record. This is no different to POST method. And in practical world, people interchangeably use PUT or POST for updating the data because the net effect is the same. So let's first understand how to use PUT. When we are using PUT, again, there's no difference to the POST. We are making use of the same URL, HTTPS Amity School Class 10 Students. And in this case, I am giving the body of a student named Susie. But since this is an update request, I know the ID of that student as well. That ID can be the roll number of the student. So in this request, I am passing the information, including the ID. In that way, the backend clearly knows which is the unique key to be used to find the record in the DB and update the information. And here, the HTTP method that is used here is PUT. Now, if I send the same request with the HTTP method POST, it would do the same business. Because in this scenario, the backend has the ID. The moment backend sees that an ID is present in the body of the request, it first tries to look up for that ID in the database. If it does not find that ID, it will create that one, Otherwise, it will fetch the record corresponding to that ID and will update it. This is nothing special. It's a basic CRUD operation, how a backend and DB operate. So that is the third method called put. Put is used to update the data. The final one and the very obvious one, which needs no explanation, is the delete method. That's used for deleting the data. So if ever we want to remove a record from the DB, that we rarely do. But let's assume we have a scenario where we need to delete the record from the DB. We set the HTTP method as delete. We use the same URL, HTTPS, MIT school, class 10, students, /10. Here, the backend looks up at the HTTP method. It understands the delete operation. And guess what? What is it trying to delete? Take a while to think before I say it. It is trying to delete the students of class 10, but someone with roll number 10. If I had not put this 10 here, and use the URL, HTTPS, MIT school, class 10, students, it would have gone and deleted all the students under class 10. That again depends upon the logic that's written behind the scenes. So these are the four basic operations or methods that are available in REST. There are two others called head and option, but that's not very commonly used, so we are not discussing here. We will concentrate on the basic CRUD operation. Hope I was able to give you a basic understanding of the REST methods that are available, which facilitate the communication between the front end and back end. Until we meet in the next video, bye for now.